Marcus, we should have done this what about 8-9 months ago when you made your debut. So finally, this is my third time lucky because it's your third fight, and my first visit to the world famous Rotunda boxing club.
Yeah, it is, but one of the most well known gyms, definitely in like the UK at least, isn't it?
I was just looking on the walls and the shirts and the plaques and the trophies. This place, it's produced some champions over the years, hasn't it?
Yeah, no, like, you can go back, as you've seen before on the wall, you can go back to like Joey Frost. I think he had like 300 amateur bouts, lost about 10. Had one of them like crazy amateur records. And obviously you've got like the Smiths, Tony Bellew, Natasha Jonas.
I was blown away. Even your coach is on the wall there.
Yeah, Joe Zechlin went the junior Olympics in USA. Must have been about
2001, I think.
2001.
Joe's 2002, and Derry Matthews was the year before in 2000.
Was he? Yeah.
I think he won a gold.
He did. Yeah, got so, gold, didn't he?
Yeah, this must give you a little bit of inspiration, that, isn't it? Training.
I remember first coming in the gym, and at the time, Callum Smith was like the top senior. He was on GB and all that, and obviously like I was looking up to him at the time.
You're still looking up to him.
Exactly. And he was the first amateur bout I ever went to watch. It was him versus Anthony Fowler. That was the first amateur fight I ever went to watch.
First of all, I forgot to mention. Happy birthday.
Oh yeah, nice one, Lee is right, nice one.
So, present was 6 rounds of hard sparring.
sparring, then a run later. That's me, I'm celebrating my 21st this year anyway.
Preparation going well though, looks like you're going well.
Yeah, feeling good. still in like the hard phase of training now, just getting fit.
Was it 3 weeks on Saturday, is it?
3 weeks Saturday, so another like, say, 2 weeks of graft and then take it down to
and this event. Show that you're fighting on the Olympia on March the 14th, it's getting bigger and bigger.
Yeah.
You know, we've got a great top of the bill. I've not spoke to you about it before, but we've got Jay Farrell against another big punching cruiserweight Damien Chambers. So it's developing into a right little battle.
Yeah, it will be good. How many fights are on? There's quite a few on it, isn't there? About 9.
There was about 7, but I think you're right now. I think there's about 9 on there now.
There's a few on, yeah. It looks like it's going to be a top show.
But well, obviously, there's a few 6-rounders. It's not just all 4 rounds.
Yeah.
A few 6s, and obviously, top of the bill being a 10-rounder.
Yeah, no, it will be a good show. Definitely the atmosphere will probably be blossoming there.
And it's been good for you, because you made your debut there against James Spade.
Yeah, that was great.
Then on the big stage.
Yeah, the Echo was my second one.
Against arguably one of the toughest.
Jamie Quinn.
Journeyman out there.
Yeah, you hit him and he just starts laughing at you.
The devil child.
Yeah, the devil child.
He's not right in the head, but not many of you boxers are, I must admit.
Yeah, true. Got to be a bit sad to do it, haven't you, the boxing.
But at 21, you must feel like you've got a bright future, mate.
Yeah, 21, yeah, I'm still, you know, in boxing terms, I'm still a baby, still loads to learn. It's funny enough, I was talking to my dad the other day about this. I was saying, I'm quite, in a way, like some people are a bit sceptical when you first turn over at that age. They think, oh, has he turned over a bit too young? But in a way, I'm happy because it's just given myself loads of time. Mm-hmm. I'm not in no rush. I'm learning every day in the gym. You know, probably still haven't even got my man strength yet. So I'm still learning. And
I was watching you there with Brian, and Brian's getting ready for a 10 rounder. So he's super fit at present.
Yeah.
But your style, it's a strange one, because I look at you and I think, oh, he's a come forward boxer, you know, boxer fighter type thing.
Yeah.
But you're not. You, even when you feel going backwards, you look like you're coming forward. You've just got to. It's like natural aggression, but actually, you've got so many different skills all mixed up. Yet it's really pleasing to watch, mate.
Yeah, like I was saying to you before, I watch boxing quite a lot. So, but I don't try and like watch one type of style. I try and, like, as I was saying before, take little bits from different people, even different times. So I'll watch fighters from like the 70s.
Who's your favourite fighter?
Right now, I'd probably say Canelo.
Yeah,
probably. Yeah. Unbelievable.
I just watched the Kirby Canelo. I think he's fighting on 2 weeks later, Lee Wheeler.
Oh,
you
know, yeah.
He looks like him.
Yeah.
He looks like he's even built like
Kirby
him as well.
Canelo, yeah. It's a good name, that. And obviously I watch, like, you know, Sugar Ray Leonard, Duran, all them types of fighters, love them.
Duran was my favourite.
Yeah, Duran and Mike Tyson are probably my favourite of all time.
We've got similar then, because both, growing up as a kid, Tyson's a year younger than me.
Is he, yeah?
But he was an absolute...
Yeah.
I don't care what anyone says. For me, the greatest heavyweight of all time, but it was only for a small period.
Yeah, sure, that's what let him down, wasn't it? He only done it for a couple of years.
Longevity is a massive part for a legacy. But for 2.5 years from when he won that title...
Unbelievable.
He was phenomenal.
Unbeatable, weren't he, really?
Yeah.
Like, how would you come up with a game plan for him?
I've never seen anyone as fast as that.
Unbelievable.
He had the speed of a lightweight.
Yeah.
You know, we talk about middleweight. No, he was just ferocious. Yeah.
Do you think he beats Ali?
He beats everyone for that period of time. Yeah. But you know, you've got to judge it on the whole career, and that's where he drops down the rankings, doesn't he?
Yeah.
But for me, Ali was the greatest, not just because of what he did in the ring.
It's like an icon, man, type of thing.
Yeah, but what he stood up for.
Yeah, exactly.
Outside the ring, people were getting shot for, killed for. Yeah. You know, Malcolm X killed, Martin Luther King killed, you know, JFK killed.
Yeah,
this was all the period that he was standing up for those things, and, you know, he didn't shy away from it, did he? So the greatest is the greatest, not for what he did in the ring for me, which was pretty amazing, but for what he did outside as well.
Yeah, I agree.
But we're going off track.
An old history lesson. It's a history lesson, that one there.
We're talking about you and this place, and like I say, first time in here, and a little bit in awe, actually.
Yeah.
Looking at everything.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah. It really is. Great, so I presume it's just, as we said before, great inspiration for you and your career.
I mean, how many is there? From this amateur gym alone, there's been 3 world champions. Mad, that, innit? Like, what are the gym can, like, really say? That's, we've got Callum Smith, Liam Smith, and Bellew. 3 world champions that I'm, like, looking up to, you know what I mean? So, hopefully, that's the path I'm going to.
Well, I wouldn't dispute it, mate. Like you say, when I watch you put a little smile on my face. That's the way I judge you.
That's right.
I remember Jamie Spate talking after you made your debut, and a guy that you wouldn't normally expect to get on your debut. He's that step up journeyman.
Yeah, because he's won like Southern Area and that, hasn't he?
So, you know, thought for the English title on a couple of occasions as well.
Has he, yeah?
You
know, so boxed there, Josh Warrington.
I think Isaac Lowe for the English title as well.
Has he, yeah?
So, you know, the kid, he's fought everyone good in the country.
Yeah.
So, for him to give you praise at the end of the fight, must give you a little bit of...
Definitely, especially when you're saying, you know, the likes of them names. I mean, look what Josh has gone on to do.
Yeah.
I mean,
but that's what I'm saying, though. But normally you wouldn't expect him in your debut. You'd normally expect him maybe four or five fights down the line.
Yeah.
To see, because he's a step-up journeyman.
Yeah, now, a bit of a test.
Jamie Quinn is that journeyman, and arguably one of the best journeymen there. But he's one of those guys that knows his job. He's not there coming to win, but he wants to give you a test, and he's ridiculously strong.
Yeah, he is. As I was saying to you before, I remember looking back at the matchroom thing of the weigh-in, and he stood next to me, and he's like that, and I'm like dead scrawny next to him.
Well, he is. He's a big lightweight, and your fighting weight is going to be super feather.
Yeah.
No idea of opponent, but it's just going to be another four rounder, is it?
Yeah, this is going to be another four rounder, this one, yeah.
shake the Christmas off you. Yeah. And then hopefully before the end of the year, maybe step up to six and even an eight rounder.
Yeah, yeah, who knows, yeah. Like, as I said, like, I'll just listen to my team.
Saying that, I'm probably jumping well ahead there because at 21, you don't really need to rush, do you?
No, no, but whenever they say I'm ready, I'm willing to go. So,
do you think that's going to help? Because these coaches were your amateur coaches, and I've been saying that, you know, the fact that your amateur coach is coming through with you means he knows you better.
Yeah,
you're got not a good having relationship, that learning period. I mean. If you went to a professional coach, you know, another pro coach at another gym somewhere, they'd have to get to know you, get to know how you work, and that could take anything from, you know, 12 months to 18 months.
Yeah, yeah.
And in those times, you don't want a real test.
Yeah, but yeah, definitely.
In 12 to 18 months, these guys already know you, so maybe you could actually bypass that and go straight for a real test if they felt you were up for it.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. I mean, as I said, why not? I listen to them whenever they say I'm ready to go. I'm ready.
Right, well, March the 14th, fight number 3. Hopefully I'll be down there chatting to you, and you will have win number 3.
Yeah, that's the one, Lee. That's it.
Marcus, take care, mate.
It's right, Lee. Bye. Nice one.
Thank you.